Even though Football Manager is clearly the greatest video game on the planet, some of those new gen faces can sometimes be a little bit... I mean, they're not all bad, but some of them really are. Well, worry not, in this video we're going to show you the simple steps to add custom faces to your game. So there's probably two situations where you'd like to add a face to the game. Maybe there's a real life player in the game that doesn't have a picture in the current face pack that you're using. Or maybe you've had a new gen come through in a youth intake and you're not keen on the default face that the game has given them. Well, in order to add a face to our game or replace a new gen's face, we first need to find out the player's unique ID number. To do that, we click on the FM icon in the top right hand corner of the screen, and then we go to preferences. And then we need to make sure that we're on this advanced tab here. If you're on the overview tab, you won't see the option we're looking for. And once you've clicked on advanced, we're going to tick this little box to show unique IDs, and we're going to click confirm. Then once your game's had a little bit of a think, you'll see that underneath the player's name, we've now got this unique ID number that's going to allow us to add a face or an image next to this player in the game. Our next task is to find the image that we want to add into the game. That's a relatively simple task. If we're doing it for a real life player, we can just type them into a search engine, find the image that we want, we can save it to our computer, and then afterwards we can manipulate that image to add it into the game. However, you're using a face pack that uses transparent backgrounds on faces. You might just want to click on tools and then color and transparent, and make sure that the image you decide that you want to use is one that's got a transparent background on it, as denoted by this little gray checkerboard. However, if you're looking for an image for a new gen player, then you're going to have to find the image that you would like to use. I've just typed a very simple term into my search engine here. I'm going to pick the first image that comes up, and I'm going to save that so that I can use that image when we head over to an editing package. The next thing we need to do is to download an existing face pack, not because we want the images particularly, but because we want what's called a config file, which is a document that comes with a downloaded face pack that basically has lines of instructions or code in there so that we can communicate with the game. I get all of my face packs and graphics from a site called Sort It Out SI. They've got different styles of face packs, some that have backgrounds on. Personally, I use this one that has a transparent background behind every player. Now, you may already have a face pack already that we can add to the config file for. If you don't, you could download one of these, but this one's got 364,000 images in it. That could put a bit of a strain on your machine, so you could just download this latest changes file that's still got 5,000 images in there, but crucially, it will have a config file in there that we can manipulate. So I downloaded one of those smaller files. It took about 2 minutes on my machine. Once you've got it, if you right click on it and click on cut, we're then going to click on documents over the left hand side of our screen, and we're going to go to the Sports Interactive folder and to Football Manager 2022. And then your list of folders might not look exactly the same as this if you've never downloaded any Football Manager graphics before. If you have that file missing, then you can just right click, create a new folder and call it graphics. I've already got one for my game, which is where I keep all of my kits, logos, my stadium backgrounds, and all of my faces as well. You can create your own folders within your graphics folder with whatever titles you deem necessary. If you make one and call it faces, then we're going to paste that document that we've just downloaded inside our faces pack. But then the next thing that we're going to do is to unpack the contents of that document that we've just downloaded. To do that, you'll need a tool such as WinZip or WinRAR, which you can download from the internet. And I'm going to extract the contents on this document here. It might take 20, 30 seconds or so to release all the images that you've just downloaded. Once that process is complete, we've now got this little folder here, and it's got all of the images in that we may have just downloaded. But more importantly for us, we're interested in this little document that is created here called a config file. Now, we'll use that config file in a moment, but first of all, we need to do a little bit of work on the image that we want to add into the game. I'd like it to look transparent like these images that we've got here, and I'd also like it to be in the same size or dimensions. So I want it to be 250 by 250 pixels. And it may well be that the images that I found are not 250 by 250 pixels. So I'm going to need to open a package so that I can resize these images and potentially maybe even remove the backgrounds if I want to as well. So the next step is to take those images we downloaded and make them fit the size of the other images that might be in our game. There's lots of packages you can do that in. You could use Photoshop if you have it. There's other tools available on the internet that you can use. I use a website known as Canva, which is very simple to use. You just go to their homepage, create an account, and then you go to custom size, and we wanted our images to be 250 pixels by 250 pixels. And if we just create a new design, it will bring us up a blank canvas that we can then add our images into. The next step is to grab the images that we want to add into the game. To do that, we're going to click on this uploads icon here, and we're going to upload some new media. And if we grab Troy Deeney, and we also grab the nameless man that we stole from the internet, then it will add them to our images that we can work with. And what we need to do is we need to drag them over to our blank canvas. We could just drop them on the page, and then we can manually resize them ourselves. But also, if we just grab the image and just drag it over and hover over the edge of the canvas, then the package will do the work for us if we want to, and it will add the image in there. But you can see we've got some dead space, some white space at the top here. So I might actually do this manually myself and put Troy at the bottom of the screen, and I'll stretch him right up there. And then I've got the image that I would like to appear in game perfectly there. And then all I've got to do is to go to share and download the image. And crucially, I need to make sure that I've got the PNG option selected as the file type, as that will allow me to tick this little box that says transparent background, so that this white edge all around Deeney here will actually appear transparent when I've got it in the game. Now, if you do want transparent images for your player faces, but you haven't been able to find a picture that already has the background cut out, well, you'll need to find a tool on the internet that's able to remove this background for you. You can do it in Photoshop if you have that package. If you're a paid user of Canva, which I have a monthly subscription to, it's as simple as just taking the image that you want to edit, clicking on edit image, and then this beach ball that stands for background remover, and within about 10 seconds it will take this entire gray background away from this image, so that you've got a transparent image that you can work with. You can then resize it to the exact dimensions that you want. For example, we might want to take it closer to the chin there, and then perhaps remove some of this white space at the top like we did with Mr. Deeney, so we can cut the image down a little bit and then stretch it out. And then we've got a perfect transparent background behind our player here. And then we can just go to share again, and we can download it like we did with Troy Deeney. Make sure we've got the PNG option selected, and then we'll have transparent background ticked, and we'll download our image ready to use in the game. Now, once those images are downloaded, you can see there are our original images, and then these are the two new ones that we've created. And crucially, both of these images are now going to be 250 by 250 pixels. So if we cut them, we can now add them in to where the rest of our images are going to be that we downloaded from Sort It Out SI. So we'll click on Documents, Sports Interactive, Football Manager 2022. We've now created a graphics folder. Maybe we've created another folder inside that called Faces. And I've created, just for the purposes of this video, a new folder with that document that we downloaded from the Sort It Out SI website. Here are all the images that were in it. We're going to scroll down all the way to the bottom, and we're going to add in Troy Deeney and our other new gen face down to the bottom there. I might even rename them. So I might call this one Deeney, and I might call this one, let's call it New Gen Face. Now we're going to open this config file in a moment, and we're going to tell it that we would like this image to appear next to a certain player when we click on them in game. To do that, we'll need to open Football Manager back up again, and we need to note down what this player's unique ID number is. Once we've noted down their ID number, it's time to do the scary bit. So we're going to open up the config file, and we're going to open it with Notepad. It's going to bring up a rather scary looking document with lines of instructions and code in there. We don't need to worry too much about this. This is why we downloaded one of these config files, so that we don't have to do the heavy lifting. All we're going to do is to highlight one of the lines of text towards the bottom, not the very bottom one that says desktop, but one of these lines that's got numbers in it. And we're going to right click on it. We're going to copy all of that. We're then going to press enter at the end of the row. We're going to tab in a couple of times. We're going to right click, and we're going to click paste. And you can see that this line from the bottom has now been duplicated so that we can edit it. So we're going to take the name of our image first of all, which was called New Gen Face. And then we're also going to take the ID number of the player that we want to add it to. For us, that was 200220. 4967. Crucially then, we need to remember to save the config file so that the game has got our updated config file there. So we'll click on save. We can then close it down, and if we head back into Football Manager, we'll see that our new gen has still got his old generated face. In order to get the face that we've just added to appear in game, we're going to click on FM. We're going to go to Preferences. We're going to find this little reset button in the bottom left-hand corner. We're going to clear the cache, and then we're going to click on the button that says Reload Skin. Now, don't worry if your game takes a moment or two to reload that skin. That's perfectly normal. But once it's done, you can click on that player and you'll find, rather than the generated face that the game's given them, they've now got the image that we added in that config file. And we can do exactly the same process with the other image that we gathered. And there you have it, you've now got custom faces in your game. So now that you know how to add custom faces to your game, why not treat yourself to watching this video by Layered Amos, who simulated the 2022 World Cup 100 times to work out which nations have the greatest chances of winning the tournament this year.